beautiful soul. Welcome back to the Tarot Closet. Welcome if you're new to the channel. Thank you so much for joining me. My name is Christine. Welcome to another All Signs Tarot reading. All signs love tarot reading. All signs love reading. So the Sun and the King of Wands has come out here. I want to show you also what's going on here. King of Wands is in reverse here in the partnership placement. So somebody trying literally to get the courage here for what? Well, we're seeing the Sun here in the first placement. Leo energy, source. The Sun connected to the solar plexus chakra. I do. You know, coming, what is coming into the light here? Are they wanting to work something out with you? It sure seems that way. A new cycle. So getting out of the cycle that you've been in, at the very least, no contact, no communication, and or in separation. Okay, so there's a lot to say, but we're obviously off and running here. Welcome to your All Signs Tarot reading, your Love Collective reading, Collective Love reading, All Signs Love reading. This is a timeless reading. You're here when you're meant to be here, so welcome again. Let's take a look at, yeah, what's on everyone's mind. Is anyone making a move? Their feelings for you? What's happening in this connection? Let's take a look at the energy coming in. It's the Six of Cups and the King of Cups. Okay, so somebody's definitely thinking about you, and they're definitely trying to get the courage here to come back in. There is a reunion energy here in the Six of Cups. Sometimes it kind of lives in that nostalgic world, you know, it doesn't move past that, but we see the Sun here. We see them trying to get the courage to move toward you. You're obviously very much on their mind. So yeah, there's something going on here, including our King of Cups, Pisces energy. What have they been holding back? Their feelings, all the feelings they've been holding back. Our master of emotions here, look, riding on this wave like it's nothing. But we can see how they feel. In fact, they're really quite deep into their feelings here, in addition to the Six of Cups, the Sun and Scorpio energy. It can be that you have known this person your whole life. We could be going way far into childhood energy. This is also a feeling, you know, that the feeling you're my person kind of energy. How far back does this go? You know, this person here who's trying to get the courage to make some kind of move toward you, to get out of this cycle of no contact, no communication, and or in separation. Perhaps for some of you, you're just having a little bit of trouble communicating with somebody. The Six of Pentacles, also here, Moon and Taurus energy. Yeah, and that's a reciprocal energy. There's a balance here, balancing out the scales, you could say. There was some one-sided energy here. It's somebody who's coming in. Yeah, what are they bringing? Is this commitment, communication, an apology? The Queen of Wands. Okay, so we saw the King of Wands. We have the Queen of Wands here, and we also have the Moon. It's a really strong validation, I want to say, of, yeah, let's just say the connection between you on a passionate level. It's also a validation that this person is not quite in balance. This Queen of Wands energy is feeling a lot like it's in reverse for me. And trying to get into that balanced energy to move towards you, obviously. So I'm talking about having seen our King of Wands here. Yeah, here it is, and of course, in the partnership placement. And it's also a validation here of the two of you. Of course, it's not about gender, but of just nobody really making the move. You know, waiting, one waiting for the other, you could say. So we have the Moon here as well, Pisces energy. Also bringing in Cancer and Gemini, Six of Cups, King of Cups energy we saw coming in. So revealing how they feel about you and communicating, opening up. This is definitely somebody from the past. How far back does it go that does want to communicate? Is obviously thinking a lot about you. You're on their mind. In fact, there is a strong nocturnal energy here. And by the way, as we talked about the dark to the what's coming into light energy, here we go. The moon and the sun, the dark to light. Subconscious energy, the conscious energy, the sun shines on the moon, illuminating everything that has been hidden. And we know that there's a whole lot of feelings there that this person has been holding back, non-reciprocal. They're coming out. They're coming in here with them. Yeah, this is pretty darn clear. Just want to mention really quickly that all your playlists are linked down below in the description, as well as the channel. Today's readings, Love Tarot readings, messages from your person, All Signs Tarot, Collective Love readings. And you'll also find all zodiac signs, as well as twin flame readings if you're on a twin flame journey. The Nine of Cups, the Seven of Cups. Okay, one cup shy of the Ten of Cups, but I'm liking this energy. Jupiter in Pisces, wish fulfillment here with our Six of Pentacles with the reciprocal energy. And yeah, had you built a life together? Were you building it? Was it on the table? Because somebody was stuck in this energy, the Seven of Cups, for probably far too long. It's in reverse. So this is somebody who is getting clarity, who's getting out of, has made a decision, I guess you could say, some commitment issues here for sure. And we could be looking at other choices, like choosing between love and work, choosing between, well, we could be looking at long distance energy here. That is an energy that is here. So perhaps there's a job or house or other people involved, you know, other decisions that obviously impacted this connection. We're seeing that they're getting clarity, like they've made a decision. We can see what it is. And in our minor arcana energy here, it's a matter of timing. Yeah, because there is a little bit of fear getting the courage, but we also see that they are. Yeah, okay, that the moon is back. The moon is back and the King of Swords is here. So we have our King of Wands in reverse. We saw our King of Cups. We're seeing our King of Swords. The moon is back. This is definitely around, well, how they feel for sure being revealed. And this is somebody who's coming in to communicate, who's coming in to open up. Look at our moon energy, that crustacean blocking the flow between you. Here it is. It's like backed up, you know, the emotions. What's been hidden? It's the moon. Ruled by the moon. The moon is ruling the tide, you know, which of course we have the emotions here, and you're both here. Somebody's been afraid. That crustacean is getting ready to get out of the way and get things flowing here. And of course, there's our sun and our moon. Yeah, this is pretty darn clear. Gemini and Mercury energy. You know, this is somebody who's been thinking about what they want to say for a long time. And there is some kind of strategy here. It's not really clear at the moment if this is around, if you can see each other or not. But that's also, okay, yeah, so it's back. That's also neither here nor there, because some of you may be able to see this person and some of you perhaps not, you know, because Mercury is connected to reading and writing. It's strong in that energy. And yeah, so the possibilities are really strong of an SMS, social media, email. And if you're here in real time, which I know not everybody is, just a little mention that we're still just getting ready to come out of Mercury retrograde. It's a little bit even wonkier toward the beginning and the end. And we're still basking in some of that full moon energy as well. So this really is just not surprising to me that somebody here is trying literally to get the courage to come here and communicate with you. This is what you want. This is wish fulfillment. So yeah, I'm really liking this energy. A new cycle here, right on the other end, our sun. Yeah. Interesting too, just a little mention here with our sun energy, the solar plexus chakra, I do. And our Seven of Cups in reverse, Venus and Scorpio energy. It's somebody here has clarity and like coming to their senses already. So we could even be looking out for some of you, some kind of energy around next level, like moving in, marriage, that sort of thing. That won't be for everyone, and we'll get some validation here in just a moment. But this is definitely somebody who, yeah, it's like Ace of Swords energy, judgment. There is a wake-up energy, and there's also a literal wake-up energy. I do feel this person has been anxious, in particular in the last, yeah, in the last days and weeks. There's some a buildup, an anxious buildup that's going on. Thank you again for joining me. I appreciate it so much. Thank you for liking today's video and subscribing to the Tarot Closet. Let's continue on. Thank you, spirit guides, angels, and ancestors. Please show us what else we need to see. Aho. It's judgment. Okay, here it is. Here's the wake-up energy. This is not surprising in the least bit. Connected to the crown chakra, I know. And Archangel Gabriel, specifically connected to the sacral chakra, I feel. And the third eye chakra, I see. The self-awareness, the third eye opening. We saw that Six of Cups. We saw that King of Cups. This is somebody who wants to open up, who wants to communicate. This is somebody who wants to start via that. You can see literally here, look, with our King of Wands in reverse and our King of Swords, that there's a little bit of fear around it. Like they're trying to get some courage here, literally. This reciprocal energy. So this is going beyond, it's going here. This is going beyond just communicating. Obviously, that is how it's coming in, whether it's in person or via message. This is something more. Archangel Gabriel asking the person coming through here today, this lover, I guess you could say, from the past coming in, what do you want? Get some clarity. Look at this. Get some clarity. Make a decision. Make a decision. Wake up. Reconciliation. There is an apology here. This is somebody definitely from your past. I don't know how far back it's going. That really, you know, who loves you? Who still loves you? Look, this is what they want. It's you. It's the Lover's card. Five of Pentacles, Six of Pentacles, just even in our buildup. But this Five of Pentacles energy, Mercury and Taurus, this is an energy of loss. This is somebody who, we're going to, of course, talk about our Lover's card in a moment. This is somebody who's missing you, who's worried, who's not actually doing that great. And here's what's really interesting. Look, as they kind of follow you. So definitely coming in with some kind of communication, maybe wonky, if there's a potential to see each other, or even just the time of day or that sort of thing, or how they come in. We also have our Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, coming in here with humility, coming in here with their reunion energy, their victory energy. They're holding on to the pentacle, getting us right here into the Six of Pentacles energy, reciprocal. So around communicating, there is an apology here, that's for sure, but this is around an offer. What does that mean for you? You know, because this is somebody who is preparing to come in here. The soulmate energy is strong, and this is definitely somebody who is, well, seeing you as their soulmate, coming together, restoring harmony. The Lover's card, of course, connected to the heart chakra, I love, and a very healing energy, our yin yang energy here. Archangel Raphael connected to the heart chakra, also the throat chakra. I speak, the communication, I love you. That's really been clear with our moon coming in twice, the revealing energy of our sun, the King of Cups, the Six of Cups, that this is somebody who is ready to apologize for some really bad judgment, some bad decisions. Has this person been afraid of some kind of major change? Because there has been a fear around this person. So were they just afraid of their feelings? Because there's a lot of them here. Afraid of next level, building a life, continuing to build a life, marriage, moving in, perhaps for some of you children. Of course, that is just not for everybody. Whatever that fear that's been going on for a while, and we could be even looking at this, that fear being a part of what's been going on here way, way back. Whatever it is, it's somebody who has gotten out of that. You know, they have clarity now. They have clarity. I guess you could say this is somebody who's getting ready or who's ready, but who is now just trying to get the courage to come here and make it happen. Our Lover's card. Restoring harmony, of course. Coming together, a very healing energy. It's right here with the Nine of Cups. Look, the Judgment energy, the Wake Up energy. Because Archangel Gabriel is literally asking, what do you want? Make a decision. Wake up here. What are you afraid of? What were you afraid of then? What are you afraid of? Get out of that fear, make a decision. They are making a decision. They've been wanting to communicate for a long time. I feel like now it's more around a fear of how they're coming, perhaps, but in terms of their feelings, those are surfacing. Those are definitely, they're clear. So they're definitely waking up and also in the night and having this realization. But it's now, I want to say, bringing that to you. And again, how far back this goes, for some of you, we could be going really really way back here, you know, in that Six of Cups energy. But that's where they've been understanding the past decisions, the past fear, and coming into their feelings and getting the truth for themselves, the clarity, and also bringing that to you. So along with this offer, with this pentacle, this commitment, recommitment, what does this mean? There is also an apology in there. There's a lot of humility here. And it's somebody who wants to do the work, who's ready to push past what they weren't before. So whatever that means, again, it could be for some of you that's around, you know, other people or locations, jobs, that sort of thing. This is so clear. The Knight of Swords, the Ten of Wands in reverse. Yeah, they have a lot to say. They also have a lot of explaining to do. Our Knight of Swords can't get in here fast enough. Even the horse is looking a little bit freaked out here. And it's Libra and Mercury energy, of course. And it's connecting with the King of Swords, with the reciprocal energy. This is literally the fear at this point. I think it's beyond what they want, how they feel. They know what they want. They know how they feel. That fear, the bigger fear of whatever is around this commitment or change, that's something I feel that they've already kind of overcome, or they've already made a decision in that way. Now it's just a matter of how they're coming in, the communication, the King of Wands in reverse, Knight of Swords, King of Swords. It's really clear. And bringing their feelings, their findings, their clarity to you, bringing it to light. The Sun into the Moon energy, Ten of Wands in reverse, Jupiter in Sagittarius. Like, this is just something that, yeah, it's a relief for this person too. It's just been something that has been going on for, yeah, again, it feels like a while, but it's been heavy on the heart. That's what I want to say. This is like a lightening up of that energy. I mean, it's the Ten of Wands in reverse. You know, it's a lightening up energy. So both in revealing the truth, revealing feelings, and also being ready to make the decision, an even bigger decision than they were ready for back then. Here is the decision. Yeah, reconciliation energy is obviously very clear. Temperance in the bottom of the deck. This is literally working it out. We could be looking at actual kind of a meeting point too, but this is the, I guess you could say, the moderation energy, Sagittarius energy, restoring balance, restoring harmony, meeting in the middle. Temperance is connected to the heart chakra. Look right here with the Lover's card, the two of you. Archangel Michael, the angel for protection and strength, getting out of fear, which is just even in this last little bit here of coming to communicate, is here and to work things out. Archangel Michael just wants to get you both here, look, into the light, here into the sun, to get out of that energy, the dark into the light, what needs to be revealed, what needs to be seen, what needs to be communicated. And it's just really, really strong around the love. So getting you both here into a new cycle on this path where everybody is happy, a happy outcome, working things out. I mean, it is so strong right here with our lover's card. Eight of Cups. Yeah, look. So that's definitely the past energy. Page of Wands, connecting with our King of Wands in reverse. You know, this is like I'm trying to figure it out energy. We could have an age difference here, but it's like a student energy, you know, and just trying to figure some things out. And obviously it's around the movement. We have the Queen of Wands coming in, the King of Wands, because you've been waiting on this person. I feel like it's needed to be this person's move somehow. And it definitely is here. This Eight of Cups, it's a really strong validation for me. It's right here with our Seven of Cups in reverse. So this obviously is somebody who's had some commitment issues and around some other choices. It could literally be, and you know this already, just around commitment, just around next level, around where things were, freaking out or where they were going. But we could be looking at other things again. And it's connecting with that energy as well with the Eight of Cups. Saturn and Pisces energy. So this person having pulled away with withdrawn energy, leaving behind energy. And that emotional energy is strong. I mean, it's the Cups. You know, it's somebody who pulled away despite the fact that they still loved you. Even here in our Two of Cups energy, bringing in the Two of Cups, Venus and Cancer energy. It really is like, yeah, next level kind of energy, Ace of Cups kind of energy. Still loving you and then being afraid. And then here we have, of course, we have Five Cups down here. And that's connecting us to the Five of Cups, Mars and Scorpio energy. Somebody who abandoned. An emotional abandonment is really strong. That King of Cups was holding back feelings, not being emotionally available, communicating, not opening up for sure. Yeah. And there's a lot of, and that's coming through here. It's really strong. This is somebody who does feel regret and is very much missing you. And we also know this all-encompassing energy here, just putting our Five of Cups in reverse, because they're asking for forgiveness as well. Ace of Wands is coming in reverse. Not surprising. It's right here with the Six of Pentacles, the Knight of Swords. Even our Five of Pentacles, the feelings that are going on of loss, trying literally to get the courage here, look to hop on their Knight of Wands. Come here with the apology, with the commitment. It's delayed. Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius energy. The Nine of Wands in reverse. Okay, and the Ten of Cups, yeah. Gosh. So there it is. This is, perhaps you were on the verge of that, or you were already there. You know, that tenth cup, because here is our Nine of Cups, of course. And this is where their energy is really strong for me. Had you built a life, were you building it? Wasn't on the table. I want to validate for you if this is around just even going exclusive, or introducing to each other's life or family and friends, blending families, that is here too. This is not just about, as we were talking about, families and children. However, that has been coming through, so I know that it's here for some of you. It's the Ten of Cups. And it's here with the Nine of Wands in reverse, the Moon in Sagittarius energy. And that's putting the Moon in reverse, and that's the clarity, and that's the truth. That's the light to the dark energy. And this reversal energy is, well, yeah, it's getting out of defensive mode. You know, it's sort of like for this person also, but for you, it's like, well, prove yourself kind of energy. And it's here with the Ten of Cups, a very beautiful energy, one that we want to see here. Nine of Cups, Ten of Cups, Lover's card, a new cycle, Mars and Pisces energy, happiness. Happiness, togetherness, love, contentment, hopeful here, the new beginning, the emotions that we know flow between you. For some of you, there is a connection here to perhaps a dwelling, had you lived near or with each other. Perhaps, again, that could be something that's needing to happen and change. But it's also just that feeling of home, the peace, the togetherness. And it's something that with this person that has been, that was interrupted for some of you for a really long time. I like this a lot for you. I want to bring in a little bit of oracle. Then we're going to bring in some channeled love messages. I'm not reading it in reverse. Thank you, spirit guides, angels, and ancestors. What else do we need to see today, Aho? There we go. Look, the crown, accomplishment. Mastery, you know, you get into that crown energy. And it's like a lot of king and queen energy here as well. And of course, connecting us to the crown chakra. I know. Connecting us to higher power energy, accomplishment. What, get up. What do you want? What do you want? Make a decision. Reconciliation with the person that I love. And by the way, yeah, there is a decision here that can be the case with the lovers, and it's definitely an energy that's here because this is somebody who, well, they're making a decision here finally. But this is somebody who has something to ask you. Nine of Cups, Ten of Cups. There's a lot to be said between you. It's somebody who loves you too. And whatever you're deciding here could be that, again, this is something we could be going into moving in marriage territory, or maybe even for some of you going back into that. But there's definitely a decision because it's where are we going from here energy. This is exactly it. Look, ship exploration. Also, look, the ocean release is here, connecting us directly to our Knight of Cups. Look, the Lover's card, even Temperance here. This person who has not been able to hold them back anymore. Also, the Ten of Wands in reverse here, who has been holding them back even from themselves. So how this is feeling really emotional, the connection between you and also the communication, and you could say the reunion energy coming together. Look, blessings, grapes, grape and blessings, this energy. So abundance. It's also connecting me to our King of Pentacles energy. What are they trying to accomplish here? Get out of their fear and contact you. And something obviously a lot bigger here. I love you unconditionally. Look, this tulip energy. One stem, two tulips. The ship exploration, the castle in alignment here. Oh my gosh. So on the same page, figuring out where do we go from here. We could even be looking at, for some of you, actual travel that is here. But it's around your life together, like where are we going from here? And right behind our castle that is adorned with all of this change, and this is representing your journey, is the sun right behind it. One of our first card coming in today on the table. The new cycle, working things out, happiness, the sun and the Ten of Cups. My gosh, the Lover's card. And here with the ship exploration, where are we going? I watched it die right before my eyes and I couldn't catch it in time. You can see here that it's moving fast. The waves are just really coming up here, and that's the water energy, of course, the emotions, the love around timing, divine timing, energy. You know, it's powered by the wind here, the sails, this ship. So this communication, emotional, where are we going from here? Decisions being made. Look at this. So a lot of things being released in terms of the feelings that have been pent up. Definitely a lot around your person, but I think for both of you, getting into alignment, where are we going from here? Connecting right here with our sun. Making this decision together, the Lover's card. Yeah, this is what it is today. Okay, I want to bring in some love messages. We're going to look at this deck here, okay? And I will bring in some other ones and we'll close your reading today. Sometimes I stay awake thinking about you. Yeah, we know that's been really, really clear, actually. So many things remind me of you. This is here in that energy where the person has been. You know, we came into your reading with the Six of Cups and the King of Cups. It's been pretty clear from the beginning. I know I messed up everything. Look at this right here with the Eight of Cups and the Seven of Cups in reverse, which is now the clarity they have, but they didn't before. And that Ten of Wands was also in the upright, which is in reverse now. A lot of stress around that. So taking the ownership of that, I know I messed everything up, obviously. Apologizing, judgment, big apology, that's too many, but that's not asking for forgiveness. I am afraid to contact you. That has literally been the energy that's been here. The King of Wands in reverse and the King of Swords. Because the bigger fear, just whatever's around the change or the commitment, here in our Seven of Cups in reverse, is also being worked out here in judgment. So the fear around the bigger picture is something that they have already been working out. But the little bits and bobs, which is our big ones, are coming here to contact you. They have been in that fear, and we know that they're getting out of that. We know that there's a lot to say, and it's really emotional. You were the best thing in my life. Look at this, yeah. Emotion, ocean release. Of course, again, just even here in the energy that we have been in, I think I want to move this here actually, with our Mercury retrograde and the full moon energy. And that's a lot of the realizations that we are talking about, the literal wake up in the night, but also the wake up energy and that Six of Cups energy and the judgment energy of, yeah, what did I do? Taking responsibility, having realizations also about how much they love you. Our infinity here with our tulip sign. For some of you, of course, this could be connecting to your twin flame. That might mean something different for you. I just need to be real. Infinity is a particular kind of love, a forever kind of love. You know, it's life force, it's balance, it's mastery, it's truth. Infinity does connect to Libra, truth, balance, and renewal. And it's right here with Temperance in the Lover's card. I know that I crossed a line with you. What was this about? I hope that you can forgive me one day. We will be together again. Because Archangel Gabriel is literally asking, what do you want? What do you want? Get some clarity. Make a decision for your life. You know, not just what they want to say. We're talking Ten of Cups here, Lover's card. Biggest wish energy. The tarot closet, love messages. I'm hiding my true feelings. That's what they have been doing. That's also been incredibly clear with our King of Cups coming in, revealing them with our moon energy, our ocean release. King of Wands, you are perfect. You're perfect. And I'm sorry I ran. Look at this right here with the Eight of Cups. You have changed me for the better. You were the best thing in my life. I know that now. So I'm hearing I was stupid. I don't really like saying that, and I wasn't going to say it, but there you go. It's what I was, asked to say. You are never far from my mind. We will be together again someday. I think of you all the time. I'm sorry. It's really more here with biggest wish energy. There's something here that wants to reveal. The Four of Wands. Look, Lover's card, Ten of Cups. The Sun. The Nine of Cups, yeah. Six of Pentacles, reciprocal, or Knight of Pentacles. Definitely the marriage energy is here. And if you can see this person, might even be that you're seeing them at a marriage or a reunion, that sort of energy. It is a reunion energy. Look, the celebratory energy, soulmate energy. It's a homecoming energy, so it could be a literal reunion if you can see this person. Even if you can't, again, it is a coming together energy, and it's a happy energy. And this can be indicating, again, for some of you, the marriage energy, because that is also connected to that, kind of a marriage card energy, for sure. Do you still love me? Look here with emotion, release the Lover's card. I want to be honest. I'm trying to be. I spy on you. Okay, Page of Swords energy, looking in. However you're connected, whether it's family and friends, social media, what, they're definitely getting information, collecting information. Do you miss me too? The last, your last channeled love message, message from their higher self. My heart belongs to you. Putting it here with the Lover's card. Yeah, this has just been a really very clear reading. As usual, and as always, it's my honor to channel for you. Thank you for joining me today. Thank you for liking today's video. I always want to fix things, even in the end of the reading. Thank you for subscribing to the Tarot Closet. I appreciate it. I'm sending you love and light, hoping for the best outcome for you, and looking forward to seeing you at another love reading soon. Until then, bye.